Hello everyone, this is Ryan here with another deck review for Hocus Pocus, and in today's video we're actually going to be looking at the Hocus Pocus 40th anniversary deck, which I'm really excited about. So in 1976, Paul Gross opened the doors to the Fresno-based Magic Shop, and with the help of his family and his two sons, he's been providing magicians, performers, and hobbyists with everything from cards, coins, gimmicks, and even full-size stage props. As a tribute to their father, Max and Cole wanted to design a deck that would commemorate the 40 years of unparalleled service. So secretly, they employed the talents of Edo Huang and insights from people all over the card community to come up with a finalized design. When they got to that point, they surprised their father with a design and launched a Kickstarter campaign. With the help of 395 backers, the deck has finally been printed and ready to be distributed all over the world. Before we take a look at the cards, let's go into the details about the tuck case. The soft touch violet case material is void of inks. Instead, sculpted gold foil and embossing contrast against the deep, rich purple hue. The company name and reworked bunny ears and hat logo sit front and center on the tuck. Wavy line work and a star-sprinkled pattern cover the majority of the background. Since 1976, sits proudly next to the encircled logo. Starred corners connect the thin line frame, and the space between the design and box edge is filled with a reoccurring ripple pattern we will see on the back of the tuck as well. One side of the box has the company name stamped in foil, and the other side denotes the country that Edo resided in while creating this deck. Hocus Pocus' website and normal logo appear on the bottom of the tuck, along with Edo Huang design and the typical USPCC information. The top of the tuck reads, "Creating Miracles," and pays homage to Paul's work with magicians of all kinds. The tuck flap has a gold embossed spade pip, and Cole and Max's initials appear on the side tabs. The back of the case features the card back design and sculpted gold foil. The hat with bunny ears logo is mirrored top and bottom, with a magic wand crossing through. Banners with the company's name and year established are present above and below. Stars and scroll work fill in the background. Inside the tuck, you'll find 56 cards made up of two jokers, a custom ace of spades, 51 number cards and core cards, a blank face card, and a double backed card. The ace of spades showcases a larger pip in center filled with scroll work pattern found on the card backs. Hocus Pocus and some more print sits below. Gold metallic ink stars are sprinkled throughout. The other three aces are decorated with the same gold stars as well. The quartz are pulled from the USPCC library and have been slightly modified in color to match the vintage purple color palette. The king of diamonds holds a tiny three of clubs. The gold ink shimmers in the light and is balanced with a rich purple and deep black. The number cards are standard in pip size and emplacement. Each of the cards has a light gray wavy background pattern that provides some unique style to the faces without being overwhelming or taking away from the playability of the deck. The pattern stops short of the card edges, allowing for an upturned card to blend in with the white borders of the card backs. The jokers feature a top hat and wand, two symbols synonymous with magic, along with a deck of cards with a six of spades and five of hearts revealed. I'm honored to say that this is a nod to my Instagram handle that Max and Edo surprised me with in honor of my reviews and photo work for Hocus Pocus. The blank cards and double backer can be used in a variety of magic tricks to produce some stunning results. The card back design is very similar to the back of the tuck, except the design is rendered in gold metallic inks and deep purples over the white cardstock. The reworked company logo and banners sit top and bottom in a classic position. Scrollwork and four-pointed stars from the ace and the tuck case are sprinkled throughout. A row of gold dots parallels a thin gold line border anchored in the corners with encircled stars. The deep purple is instantly recognized and conjures ideas of royalty, magic, and mystery. The gold tone ink contrasts against the purple and gives a majestic feeling while adding to the vintage feel. The rippled wavy pattern on the card backs is ghosted in a lighter purple. USPCC printed this deck with their bicycle stock with air cushion finish, a choice Hocus Pocus felt would fit the majority of their customer base, considering the number of bicycle decks they've sold over the years. Clean edges and a comfortable, familiar feel are hallmarks of the handling of this deck. Only 2,500 decks were printed, and considering it's an anniversary deck, they will not be printed again. When setting up the Kickstarter campaign, Max wanted to reward collectors, so there was a pledge that included an uncut sheet that will not be for sale. But you might see one in a giveaway, so keep your eyes peeled. This deck has some deep personal meaning to me. I remember when this was just a wild idea with a hope it would happen one day. Max, Cole, and Edo worked really hard to bring a unique deck to the playing card market. There's not many decks out there today that can pull off a purple color palette, pattern faces, while capturing a vintage feel that commemorates a 40-year family-owned and operated magic shop, all while still being playable and collectible.